Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. Fundile Nyathi. I've been asked by the Healthcare Heroes Memorial to be the director of this evening's memorial service in honor of the late Dr. Norman, AKA Malombo Sibula. But I need to greet you all in all the South African languages. So I'll start by saying, Ripirile, Ndimateguana, Dumelang, Huyenand, Molweni, Lichonile, Buanoid. So today, like I've just said, it's a memorial service for the late Dr. Norman Sibula. Now we have a program that's quite low, about 16 items. So my duty is just to efficiently ensure that we go through the program in the shortest possible time. And so that's my duty, but there's many people who will be assisting with the responsibilities, playing videos and showing other things. So my duty is just to make sure that we move very quickly through the program. So before we get to the program, I just want to find out if Reverend G.S. Moyane is in the house or not, because we need to start with an opening prayer. Is Reverend G.S. Moyane there? Is Reverend G.S. Moyane? Okay, Pastor Joyce M. Shihunda, are you the one who's gonna do the opening prayer? Okay. Well, in terms of the program, all right, let me just look for Reverend Moyane. Sorry.
I'm here, program director, do you hear me?
All right, now I can hear you very well. Let me hand over to you. You know, you are supposed to, you know, ensure that we start this program by involving, you know, our creator to bless this event. So please, over to you, Reverend Moyane.
Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Shall we pray? Father God, we come before your throne of grace this evening. Father God, with our prayers of thanksgiving, adoration, and petition, as we say, thank you, Heavenly Father. This is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Father God, about to begin with the program for the day, we feel it necessary to invite you. As you say, come down, Holy Ghost, and guide us. Guide our master of ceremonies. Guide all the speakers that will be talking here. And guide most of all the word of God. And Father God, as we commemorate here, we think of your dear son, Dr. Sibula, who's no longer with us here. Father God, we are praying for his soul, that may his soul rest in peace and rise in glory. When you see him coming from far, invite him, Father God, and say, welcome and well done, good and faithful servant of the Lord. You have been faithful with little things and are put in charge of greater things. Come and sit at the right hand of God the Father. Come and sleep at the bosom of Abraham. The old is gone and the new has come. May his name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you. Amen and amen. Amen. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Reverend G.S. Moyane. with the opening prayer. But here, according to the program, it's opening prayer and a sermon. So I'm not sure if we should go on and you know, and have the sermon at this point, because after that, we will then go to the obituary reading by Mapilo Sibula, the daughter to the late Dr. Sibula.
Program director, thank you so much. You people, you'll forgive me. I'm just in a car. I just stopped somewhere just to do what I've been requested. We just came from the physical memorial service of Dr. Spula. It has taken much time than one anticipated. But even if it is like that, I will continue with what I have been requested. I will just give you a sermonette, not a sermon, because of this is virtual. I'm quite mindful of the data and the time that is allocated for us. I'll be very brief though. Program director, allow me. I am here reading in the epistle according to 2 Timothy chapter, let me have my Bible here. 2 Timothy chapter 4. I'm going to read verses 6 up until to verses 8. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 6 to verse 8. And after that, I'll just give you a very short message. And it read as follows, says, as for me, I've already been poured out like a wine of offering. My time for my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. There is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous God, will give on that day, not only unto me, but unto all those who have loved his appearing. Thus far goes our scripture reading for this evening. Program director, may I take this opportunity to show my respect to all the people that are here. First of all, to you, our program director, Dr. Fundile, and to the bereaved family of the Sipula, and to all the doctors and all ladies and gentlemen who have joined this memorial service. There is a quotation that I like most by Miles Monroe when he said, the value of life is not its duration, but its donation. You hear that one? The value of life is not its duration, but its donation. There are people who live for quite a short period of time, but having donated so much, there are those who live for quite a long time, but donate nothing. I think here we are commemorating somebody who has lived such a very short period of time. We still expected a lot to come from Dr. Norman Sipula, but the Lord has seen that he has done his part. He has run his race and he has completed his race. Ivan Khoza, Dr. Ivan Khoza has these words to say, and I quote him. He says, long life is not good enough, but good life is long enough. Do you hear that one also? Long life is not good enough, but good life is long enough. We are also commemorating somebody who lived a good life. I've been very close to this man, Dr. Sipula. He has lived such a good life. A person whose heart was easily touched at the suffering of another person, more especially his own patient. He's one person who has taken his patient's life first before his. The scripture reading that I just read, the program director, is St. Paul himself. while he was passing a baton to a young man called Timothy, the one whom he has groomed himself. And he says to Timothy, Timothy, as for me, I have been poured out like a wine of offering. I have fought a good fight. I have run the race. And I have completed the race. And nothing awaits me if it is not the crown of mercy. That will be bestowed not only unto me, but unto those who have labored very well. I just want to mark two things here. St. Paul is taking our lives in our own homes, in our own professions. He identified it with an athlete. He identified it with some field activities. The first thing, he identifies it with two athletes who are within the ring, who have to box each other. And he says, as for me, Timothy, I have fought the good fight. You know, in life, we have to choose the battles that we fight. He says, I have fought the good fight. There are certain battles that are very useless, that they don't worth fighting for. But he says, as for me, I have fought the good fight. And I fought from round number one up until to round number last. And when I don't hit the air, but I hit the flesh. I have fought the good fight. This man that you are commemorating today, he was a kind of a person who knew which battles to fight and which battles are very useless, not to waste your time, your energy, and your resources to fight such things like that. And he fought the good fight. And the fight in the field of medicine, he fought this fight, I think, Dr. Spuler, he has cured a lot of people, you know, during this time of COVID-19. And he was doing it proactively and reactively. Some of us, he has given us some medicines and said to you, Reverend, I know you are this much old. I've got something for you. Come and take it. He was fighting this battle of the COVID-19 that is terrorizing us here in the country. And today it is himself who's no longer with us. But what we rejoice about is that he has fought the good fight. Some of us are remaining behind here. We are still alive. We can still take good care of our families. But he himself is no longer there because he has taken the life of his patient first before his own. And St. Paul continues to say, I have run the race and I have completed the race. I ran from number one up until I complete the race and I have touched the rope. And this is the kind of Dr. Spuler. He has run the race in the field of medicine and he has completed his race with a very clean record. You know, there are those athletes, when they run, they just want to be seen by people and from there they just disappear. And we know the kind of the marathon that people are running. Watch the marathon when people are running. There are those who run first and even run before the TV so that people can see them. And from there, they disappear within thin air. But there are those athletes who run up until the last mile. I remember Dr. Spuler. He has run this race of medicine. Even the time when his own health was not good, we saw Spuler running, helping other people up until he touched the rope, being in his calling in the field of medicine. Oh, what a great man of God. And we believe that wherever he is resting with the Lord because of he has run a good race and he has completed the race. I cannot forget while I was still a student in Pietermaritzburg, there was a marathon that was running from Pietermaritzburg to Durban. There was this athlete who was running, and when he saw the rope in front of him, his legs could not carry him. But when he fell down, he never gave up. He crawled on his knees. He crawled on his knees up until he touched the rope and said, I have run the race and I've completed the race. That is the kind of Dr. Spooler. Sick as he was, Dr. Spooler was still giving prescriptions to people, being sick himself. And he has done that. As we are meeting here, my doctors, my professors, and everybody who's here, I always say, to be a reverend, to be a doctor, to be a nurse, to be a teacher, is not just a profession, but it's a call. And you have to be loyal to your call up until the last. In the book of Colossians chapter 3, verses 23, it says, when you serve other people, serve them as if you're serving God himself, because you are not in a profession, but you are in a call. And I always say a profession, like a doctor, like a teacher, like a reverend, is like antibiotics. You will understand me yourselves as the doctors. Always you need to give us prescription and give us antibiotics. It is written, finish the course. A calling, when you have been called by God, you need to finish the course. As a doctor, you need to finish the course. As a nurse, you need to finish the course. Don't just live in between. Difficult as it is, meeting such lot of challenges in your profession, but we have seen you soldiering on. Even during this time of COVID-19, we have seen your surgeries been flocked up by a lot of people coming for assistance, but you have been there. I want to encourage you that soldier on, finish the race, finish the antibiotics of your profession. Up until at an end, you'll be able to say, like Dr. Spooler, I've run the race and I have completed the race. And what Dr. Spooler also says, as I want to conclude, as St. Paul says, he says, I ran the race and I kept the faith. Hallelujah. I kept the faith. I was not just running, but I kept the faith. You know, faith is like the people who are running the relay race. The relay race, you can run as fast as you can, but what makes you to win at an end is the stick in your hand. You can run as fast as you can, and you come and you reach and you touch the rope, and the stick is not in your hand. You are being disqualified, because what makes you to win the race is the stick in your hand. And St. Paul says, I ran the race and I had the stick in my hand, which was my faith, and I kept the faith up until I touched the rope. He has kept the faith up until I touched the rope. He says, I finished the race, because if you don't have the stick in your hand, you are going to be disqualified. Oh, what a bad thing for a person to be disqualified in your calling. Dr. Spooler has run the race, has finished the race without any red card or a yellow card. And he ran up until he finished the race. And I want to say to the family, and I want to say to you as the colleagues of Dr. Spooler, that this man has fought the good fight. This man has run the race and he has completed the race. And may the Almighty God bless him, and may the Almighty God, you know, receive him when he see him coming from very far, and to say, welcome and well done, good and faithful servant of the Lord. You have been faithful with little things, and I'll put you in charge of greater things. Come and sit at the right hand of God the Father. The old is gone and the new has come. You have run the race and you finished the race. Rest in peace. God bless you all. We are praying for you in your profession, in your calling. May the Almighty God bless you, and may the soul of Dr. Norman Spooler rest in perfect peace and rise in glory. Amen and amen. Thank you so much.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you very much, Reverend Moyane. Thank you for the spiritual food that you've just given us. Thank you for contextualizing, you know, the life of, you know, Dr. Sebula. My takeout from what you've just said in your sermon is that the value of life, it's not the duration, but the donation. And for me, that means, you know, irrespective of the time that you are here on earth, you must make an impact, a positive impact to the rest of humanity. You mentioned that he was loyal to his calling until death. He was able to keep the faith. He ran his race, he completed his race, and he touched the rope, even when his health was at risk. But he still continued to do what he came here on earth to do. So thank you very much for that powerful sermon, Reverend. And now after the Reverend, we are going to have an obituary that's going to be read by the daughter to Dr. Sebula, late Dr. Sebula, Mapifo Sebula. Is she here? Because she is the next person then who is supposed to read the obituary. Is Mapifu here? It does not seem like Mapifu is here. Maybe we will get back to the obituary once she is in the call. Let's move on to the fourth item, which is colleagues to the late Dr. Sebula. We'll start with Prof. Sam Risenga, who is a special colleague. Can you help me to enable Mapifu? Right, just hold on, Prof. Risenga. Mapifu, can you enable Mapifu so that she's able to come in? All right, I think it won't do any harm if we proceed to the colleagues of late Dr. Sebula, and then we'll get back to the obituary by Mapifu, you know, after we've had those two. It will be Prof. Sam Risenga, and then followed by Prof. Sam Munogwani. All right, so Prof. Sam Risenga, over to you.
To the program director, to Reverend Moyane, to the Sebula and the Zubugela families, to all Alantela residents, alumni, and colleagues that are here today, I would like to greet you. It is indeed a sad day for us to be bidding farewell to our friend, to our colleague, and also to our comrade. On the other hand, we would like to celebrate Malombo's life, which was well lived, as the Reverend has said. Malombo was brought up by his grandmother, as he lost his parents while he was young. So as a result, this helped him to develop entrepreneurship while he was still a small boy. And he used to sell peanuts in trains and other communities, and also sell at Marawastad in Pretoria. This really helped to sustain him and his grandfather, grandmother, and siblings. I knew him long before he came to Alantela residence. This is because he came from Giani, and because of his many talents in terms of playing soccer for Giani High School and also for local clubs that were there then. There was one called Chelsea, which he played for, and also another one called Giani First 11, which used to compete a lot. due to his soccer prowess and ability to create games, his team used to win with ease. Some people used to call him a soccer wizard. Because he was a man of many talents, apart from playing soccer, he also was an actor while he was in high school. There was a play which was called Women Are Dangerous, which was written by one of his teachers. He used to play a certain Mr. Morgan, and he had a son. This Mr. Morgan had a son who's now Professor Titi Zanwesi. Malombo excelled in class and hence his admission into medicine at the University of Natal, where at that time it was very difficult to get spaces because of the fact that black people only were allowed to go to the University of Natal. So it was really a fight to get in. But for somebody who had other extramural activities, very active in many things, to be admitted, it was really admirable. No sooner had he come to rest, he became a popular figure due to his simplicity, to his assertiveness, and also wearing a smile all the time. He also became part of the University Rangers, which was the soccer club of the University of Natal Black Section, and he excelled in whatever position he would be playing. He would show his soccer skills and finesse and was a soccer genius. He was competitive in a friendly way, compassionate, and a people's person. Alantera Residence at that time was a big family, and there used to be parties, what we used to call Goomba over weekends, Goombas over weekends. If you found Malombo in a Goomba, doing his things in terms of dancing and jiving, he would look like he's drunk, and yet he was a teetotaler. That was the kind of man that Malombo was. He managed to balance his studies with other extramural activities that he was involved in, such as being a photographer and also a videographer at weddings. So he used to make extra funds from that. There was a time when he was at a hotel residence when actually he used to feed kitchen units for people in the townships. That showed entrepreneurship in him. It was not surprising that he ended up being involved in businesses, being a businessman, apart from being a medical practitioner. He was a compassionate human being and had a very likable personality. I don't remember anybody that really had a fight with Malombo during the time that I knew him. When I left medical school, I left him there to complete, but we used to meet when he came to Giani and I went to Malamulele where I lived. Our roads again met when we were at the George Mukhari Hospital in Karangua, when he came as a houseman and I was a registrar in pediatrics. We continued life together. We had a lot of fun. He's a man who liked finer things in life. While at Dr. George Mukhari Hospital, he used to drive a Porsche, a small Porsche, that was very, very beautiful. Now, what reminds me about this Porsche is that there was a time one day when I was getting into doctor's quarters, we used to get in through a boom gate. Now, the guards took long to open the boom gate. Malombo just drove through it, but he went under it because his car was very low. It was such that everybody had to laugh. That was the kind of man he was, who would make you laugh, even if you were not happy. Malombo opened a practice in Davitton after he had completed his internship. And it was a lucrative practice. And I used to do locums for him while I was still in Pretoria. He came, he built a very beautiful, clinic in Davitton and called it Kubeni, which means Mama Kuba, who was his grandmother that brought him up. So it was in honor of the grandmother, that name. He opened it with fanfare and also with party, because that's how Malombo was. He was a man that used to enjoy life. He actually jokingly one time told me that you, Sam, you were superintendent of Malamulele Hospital. I'm superintendent of my own hospital. You see the entrepreneurship in me. That was Malombo. Due to the fact that he always enjoyed dealing with challenges and exploring new things, he moved to Mozambique to go and establish a health center there called Masana and also a hospital called Bethesda. I visited him now and then, and he would show me around, which was very, very enjoyable to see a South African, to see a friend, to see a person that grew up in poverty, building something for the community so that people should benefit. One of the other many talents that he had was that he could speak many languages, both in South Africa and in the SADC region. He had the gift of learning languages fast, a real polyglot. He established a company called What If, which was a visual medical platform. This company won prizes, especially with Vodacom. There are people, some doctors, that are actually using it to render health services even outside the borders of South Africa, in the whole world. There are many business enterprises that he was involved in. I think that one would be, as the obituary is read, they are going to be mentioned. So I wouldn't like to repeat. Now, when he came back from Mozambique, we used to meet, especially if they are choir singing or if there's opera, because he loved choral music especially. To the Vukela and Sipula families, and also to his children, Hiri Rifambile Jara Mgingriko Rasugingi Ulandile Mikwebu Yagabona Mintiro Yakwe Yivulavurile Haitumelanga Nakangwe Yivonakile Himani Namani Eka Ndiyangu Wayena Lo Awuranda Kaswangazi Ndiri Eka Ngwina Amilofungulo Lwa Buwa Yesukwembu Awabankari Wakwe Wohunza Labi Sabini Ulofika Tani nesunga tafika la mani na mani kwa anga kuchopete ni la msabini. Salani miti nyungu bisa mintura ya yena le I endreke. To his children, I would like to say, please continue with your father's legacy. Malombo, we shall really miss you as Alantela resident alumni and all colleagues, including the nation at large. May your soul rest in peace. I thank you, Chairperson.
Thank you so much, Prof. Sam Rizenga. You've given us, an overall view into, Dr. Malombo, his entrepreneurial, skills, where it started. You've told us about his excellence in football, hence the name Malombo. You've told us that he was a socialite and the life of a Goomba, somebody who liked the finer things in life, but somebody was able to balance being a doctor and also being a healthcare entrepreneur, having a good life, having fun, but also being impactful. Thank you so much. We're now going to have Prof. Rudo instead of Prof. Sam Munogwane, on behalf of the UKZN alumni. So over to you, Prof. Rudo.
Good evening, Chair Dr. Mojapelo, the Vugela family, the Sipula family, colleagues and friends, Ms. Poha the Haverim, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Dayan Ha'emet. Blessed art thou, Lord, ruler of the universe. Blessed art thou, Lord, ruler of the universe and the true judge. You have ruled and judged that this is the time that you will take your servant Malombo away from us, as you do with the righteous, to take them from strife. ATR alumni, I am addressing you. When we walked through the gates of the old barracks that lay along the oil refinery road, next to the oil refinery that was spewing fumes that were laid with sulfuric acid, we were young, we were gifted and black. We were full of life. Nothing could bring us down. And one of us was Malombo. We were dreaming large. We were dreaming big. We had goals. We knew we wanted to be doctors and go out and serve our people. What was unique about Malombo was his indomitable spirit. I was trying to try and remember whether I ever saw Malombo angry on any one single day for the duration of the time that I spent at Allen Taylor residence, and the answer was a resounding no. He always wore a smile on his face and nothing ever put him down. And he had no boundaries to not make friends. And yes, Professor Risenga, he had a body that didn't have bones when he was dancing at Goombas. And he would just pop into your room when you were studying and said, I'm visiting you. Aren't you going to serve me a drink? And you would take your last few rands and go down to the canteen and buy a cold drink and serve him. I also knew Malombo as a family member because he's an uncle to one of my nephews. And as a family member, I experienced a very generous spirit. He was a special person. And you know the kind of things we got up to at address. And maybe some of them shouldn't be said in a large public, but you know that come Friday afternoon, books down, partying all the way until Sunday night when we could no longer stand and we knew we were going to school on Monday. It didn't matter whether we were writing tests on Monday. This was the lifestyle. And we survived it because we were young, but we also encouraged each other. So I would like to say to you, soon we will all come to the end of life's journey like our brother did. And perhaps we will never meet anymore till we gather in heaven's bright city, far away on that beautiful shore. And Malombo, if we never meet again, this side of heaven. As we struggle through this world and its strife, there is another meeting place somewhere in heaven. It's a little bit like ATR. It's just a little bit more controlled though. It is by the side of the river of life, where the charming roses bloom forever, and where separations come no more. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore. They say that we shall meet by the river, where no storm clouds ever darken the sky. And they say that we'll be happy in heaven, in the wonderful sweet by and by, if we never meet again this side of heaven, as we struggle through this world and its strife, there definitely is another meeting place somewhere in heaven, Malombo, by the side of the river of life, where the charming roses bloom forever, and where Yahweh spreads his wings of mercy, of love, to envelop us, and we shall never separate again, all of us from Allen Taylor residents, all of us colleagues in our noble profession, all of us your family, all of us your friends, we will not part. And Chair, I would like to just conclude here. And I hope I have covered my colleagues, because I had to center some of the things that we did at Allen Taylor. I will finish with the priestly blessings that we always pray in my family. And this is going out to everybody, especially to you who are heartbroken, who remember the young Malombo, who are visualizing the smile, who still cannot believe that he's gone, for he is not truly gone, because he lives on in our hearts. May Yahweh bless you and guard you. May Yahweh shine his countenance upon you and be gracious to you. May Yahweh turn his countenance towards you and grant you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Prof. Madiba. Thank you. You gave us also a snapshot, a view about life at Allen Taylor Residence. For those people who don't know Allen Taylor Residence, this was, army barracks from the Second World War that were used to house Black students because they could not stay at the main campus at the University of Natal because of Group Areas Act. It was not a very healthy space because it was next to an oil refinery. So we all inhaled, polluted air for a minimum of 6 years. But in spite of the lousy environment, it was a very good place to develop people. And what we are hearing from Prof. Rudo is that once again, as young, gifted, and Black students who are doing medicine, they balanced their studies with a social life. And Prof. Told us that Dr. Malombo was always at the center of the Kumbas, the camaraderie that developed there, the dreams that were there, that you know, people would go out and make a difference. So thank you very much, Prof. Rudo, for you know helping us to understand a little bit better. And like you said, he is not gone. His spirit lives on in our hearts till we meet again. So thank you very much. We will now move on to a hymn, his favorite hymn, Lava Tirela Ka Yehova. You know, can we have that hymn? I'm not sure who's supposed to sing it, you know, but that's his favorite hymn. And after that, we will once again go back to the obituary from Mapivu Sipula, if she's here. If not, then we'll go to the tribute from Kubeni Sibula.
Come on,
Thank you so much. Now we will move on to the reading of the obituary by Mapefu Sipula, the daughter to the late Dr. Sipula. Mapefu, over to you. Is Mapefu here?
Good evening.
Good evening.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It is my honor to be given this opportunity to read Dr. Norman Sipula's biography. It reads as follows. Norman Nauzau Sipula was born in 1995 in Lady Selborne, west of the city of Tshwane. Dr. Nau Sipula's 42 years in the health field began with tertiary training in medicine at Nelson Mandela School of Medicine, University of Natal, where he earned his MBCHB degree in 1985. He took his fellowship at George Mukhari Academic Hospital in Harangua in Tshwane. A lifelong learner, he subsequently earned his PhD at Stellenbosch University in 2006, and also completed the Global Health Delivery Program with cum laude through Harvard University in 2018. After completing his medical training, he spent 30 years of professional life as a primary health care doctor specializing in non-communicable diseases, HIV, AIDS, and TB. He has extensive work experience implementing integrated primary healthcare infrastructure development for low middle income countries. He is a respected and honored people's doctor. He worked in East Rand Black Township of Davitel in Ekurhuleni Metropolitan Municipality of Gauteng in South Africa from 1986 to 1998, and in Maputo, Mozambique from 1998 to 2014, establishing new models of primary care clinics and healthcare financing models for lower income people. He's a founder and the CEO of the global multi-award-winning What If Health Portal, with a demonstrated history of significant contribution to global health delivery systems. A thought leader in the area of augmented artificial medical knowledge systems. An innovator in digital health solutions that addresses global shortage of healthcare workers, provide users with integrated clinical decision support solutions for chronic disease management to pursue sustainable development goals and equitable universal health coverage. A member of ITUHU focus group on artificial intelligence for health and part of the team leader on artificial intelligence in cardiovascular risk predictions. Current product range and products: home-based advanced clinical care for hypertension, diabetes, and cardiac conditions. Integrated digital platforms used to screen mental health, breast, cervical cancer, skull cancer, and prostate cancer. What If also digitized the South African ANC record system and succeeded in bringing ordinary community health care workers in mainstreaming clinical work as an ANC assistant. Every child in the village is a differentiated service delivery model for children under 5. The smart digital platform in indicative paperless digital application for ordering laboratory test and sharing results with a proprietary integrated chronic disease and management platform and automates patient care conditions, conduct care pathways, gap analysis, and provide doctors with interactive clinical decision support tools, scheduling of chronic patients. Dr. Spula will always be fondly remembered for his magnificent and passion for innovative digital health projects, which bridge the digital divide to bring state-of-the-art healthcare to the least privileged in low- and middle-income communities. We remain forever indebted to him and committed to continue his legacy of work. May his soul rest in peace.
Thank you so much, Pastor Joyce. Thank you for reading that obituary. As we can see, you know, and reflecting on the opening sermon, which was talking about, you know, the value of life, it's not the duration, but the donation, meaning it is about the impact that one makes during their lifetime, irrespective of how long that life is. Now, from that obituary, we certainly know that he gave, you know, his life to his patients. He was able to pursue his entrepreneurial dreams, solving health problems here in South Africa, the rest of the SADC, you know, region, Mozambique specifically. He was very much committed to primary healthcare, integrated primary healthcare. He was, you know, also very busy in terms of using technology to ensure that people can access services, you know, in areas where some of the services could not be brought. So he actually, you know, his departure is a loss to South Africa. It's a loss to the SADC region, and it's also a loss to the world, because he was collaborating with, you know, institutions like the WHO. So, but thank you very much. And I know also there's somebody here from, Ruth Field from AstraZeneca, who was working very closely with Dr. Malombo in terms of digitization of a cancer, you know, intervention program, you know, awareness, education, screening, and early detection. And so the departure of Dr. Malombo will certainly, you know, create some setbacks for the program. So we will move on to another speaker. This one, it's a tribute once again from one of his daughters. Kubeni Sibula is there, please take the floor. Kubeni Sibula, she there? All right, maybe let's skip that and move to the legacy video. The support staff, can you please play the legacy video? Thank you so much with that legacy video. Once again, you know, it gives us, you know, a whole picture of the person that we are here to celebrate today, you know, Dr. Sibula, affectionately known as Malombo. You know, we saw different sides of him, sleek dresser, stylish all the time, you know, permed hair for those who were, you know, already adults in the 80s, they would know that, you know, socialites would actually have permed hair. We saw him, you know, dancing in the Kumbas, you know, and with his trademark later, trademark salt and pepper beard, you know, like former President Mutante, you know, with that black beret that was a trademark of his. And one thing that we also saw that, you know, during those days, in his younger days, he certainly was a baby magnet. So yeah, but let me move on. We're now gonna have his business associate at What If Health, Mr. Sugen Mudli. Mr. Sugen Mudli, over to you. Do we have Mr. Sugen Mudli or somebody, you know, who can talk from What If Health? Is there anybody from What If Health that is designated to speak? Right, we'll move on to a colleague from the Davidin Independent Practitioner Association, Dr. Shay Udderton. Dr. Shay Udderton. So over to you. Dr. Shay Udderton. All right, we don't seem to have Dr. Shay Udderton, and also we don't seem to have somebody from What If Health, Mr. Sugen Mudli. We will therefore move on. We're going to call upon Dr. Maggie Mujapilo, but before she comes, we will have a few minutes of a video from the Healthcare Heroes Memorial. We won't play all of it because it's quite long, it's about 15 minutes, so we'll only play about 4 minutes of it. Over to you, support from Healthcare Heroes. Play that video, just about 4 minutes and no more. Thank you.
when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We could go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change. We all are part of God's great big family. And the truth, you know, love is all we need.
Thank you so much. As you can see in that roll of honor, you know, the last 2 years has been very, very heavy on people in the healthcare professions. So many professors that we've lost, so many specialists that we've lost, so many, you know, general practitioners, so many nurses, you know, you know, they are all, you know, people who were heroes who made a difference to the lives of the communities here. So we will then move on now to Dr. Maggie Mutapilo, Healthcare Heroes Memorial, about the DUOPEC presentation. Dr. Maggie Mutapilo, or AKA Dr. Megs, over to you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Fundile. The purpose of that video is to highlight the tornado that has befell healthcare workers in the past 2 years. That video, it is simple yet significant. You can see few names when we launched this memorial, Roll of Honor. That was our first launch when it was launched. If the audience go to the version 4, you will find that there is a sea of healthcare professionals, doctors, nurses, hundreds of them we have lost, and we have lost approximately 1,366 today. Program director, the family, Reverend Muyani, all the professors and doctors and our colleagues locked in tonight. The Healthcare Heroes Memorial, in collaboration with the Fundi Channel, is extremely humbled and honored to be part of this iconic event as we pay tribute in our unique ways to one of our own colleagues, a father, happy uncle, brother, grandpa, indeed, our healthcare hero. Dr. Malombo, affectionately known, made an incredible mark and difference to his family, his community, and indeed to many of us, especially the Alan Taylor Rest Plan, where his persona towered over us with his charisma, as well as within the health fraternity. Healthcare Heroes Memorial, inaugurated months ago as COVID descended our shores and cost many lives of our doctors, professors, nurses, and other healthcare workers. This iconic digital platform that we have seen is in the form of a roll of honor and image memorial of our healthcare workers. Professors, today we have lost about more than 25 of them. Not ever in our history have we lost so many of our professors, let alone our nurses and our doctors. And it was formed at the time when we couldn't be together, when we couldn't be with our colleagues, when we couldn't say goodbye. And COVID was taking us fast and furious. To date, as I've said, we've got about 1,366 healthcare workers that we have lost, that has since departed, since COVID started. Today, the Healthcare Heroes Memorial humbled itself to have conducted hundreds of memorials nationwide and overseas of our colleagues. The foundation has evolved to form Healthcare Heroes Legacy Fund for scholarships and beneficiaries of healthcare workers, children left behind. The importance of this event tonight is to memorialize and honor our colleague, Dr. Nao Norman Sipula. Indeed, tonight, we are proud to memorialize one of our own on the healthcare workers' roll of honor and memorial. It is important to note that behind every name on the roll of honor is a beautiful family left behind. That being said, we would like graciously to thank the family for allowing us to memorialize their loved one, our colleague, to join the other colleagues on the roll of honor in life and beyond, to be part of this highest honor that we can highlight of his legacy tonight. This is a legacy story, and today we write that story. Tonight we write that story indeed, and not only write, but preserve the indomitable healthcare hero's life story. It is the Malombo's meritocratic life story that we're talking about today, that we are cherishing today. I always talk about the E's equations or the B's or the A's, but in case of Dr. Malombo, or the E's equation of excellence, exploration, endurance, and innovation. And today I also learned another E to his equation, the entrepreneurship. I had four here on my speech, but I'm adding the other five based on what we have heard. Excellence excelled in soccer. We have heard Professor Lasinga. He excelled also in style. We have heard was one of the few young doctors who drove a Porsche. And of course, exploration. His explorative persona saw him crossing borders to deliver quality healthcare to many. The clinics in Mozambique and the hospital, that is exploration par excellence. Endurance persona. And indeed, to complete med school and go into the world and save lives at the expense of your own. That is endurance beyond imaginable. Innovate, utilizing technology to enable healthcare access to many. As we know, not too many of us, healthcare workers or doctors within our field, can be classified as health technopreneur. Malombo was one, and it is this quality that our paths crossed when he pioneered Watif, a healthcare porter, and of course, the lifestyle diseases being now number one killer. It was innovation beyond. One wouldn't say much about that porter. It has won many global awards. So that's the innovation, the health technopreneurship in Malombo. And of course, the entrepreneurship, we have heard that not just, he was just not a doctor, but he migrated into the field of business. So this is equation legacy we will keep on and uphold. Healthcare Heroes Memorial with all other health formations wishes to present this significant honor that we bestow upon the family, the Healthcare Heroes Duopack. We will see shortly. This is a significant and iconic symbol and token of appreciation that we bestow upon the families. The hero's candle of light and hope, here it is towering, a big giant mega candle. We are saying with this candle, the hero's candle, Malombo's hero's candle family, we are saying the light will keep on shining to the family from this candle and all of us for generations to come. Let this candle be lit at anniversaries, at different special occasions related to Malombo, to the family. And of course, next to it, we've got a certificate of respect and honor. This is the certificate that is from the Heroes Memorial and all health formations that are working with us in collaboration. We collaborate, we hereby present the Heroes Certificate of Respect and Honor. We call it Heroes Duopack to the family. They are ready here, and they will be delivered to the family in some days to come. In conclusion, a tree, unless watered, is like a tree that never was. Thanks, Malombo, for congregating us, especially the Alan Taylor Res Group, and other friends and colleagues for congregating us on this special day of your memorialization. Thanks for watering your family well, as we have seen with the speeches. And all of us and generations before you, with your ease equation, we will never forget. Graciously and humbly, thanking you all, I thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Max. Thank you. You touched on, some serious, stats in terms of how many people, in the healthcare space have actually lost their lives during this 2 years of COVID. 1,366, and about 25 professors that have been lost to date. You touched also on his passion to be part of solution in terms of the number one killer in South Africa, which is the non-communicable diseases. At least 54% of deaths in South Africa as per Stats SA and now as a result of complications of NCDs. South Africa, the SADC has certainly lost with the passing of Dr. Sipula, but also it has lost many other professionals, you know, in the healthcare space. He leaves a strong legacy, and his work as a healthcare entrepreneur will continue, for those people who will continue with What If Health, and also those who are inspired by his, work here on earth. So that's about all as far as the speech, from Dr. Maggie Mujapilo, and that UOPEC will be presented to the family in the coming days. Now we are going to go to Dr. Nozuko Mgabayi, who's going to be reading the Hippocratic Oath. Dr. Mgabayi got to medical school at the University of Natal and Alan Taylor Residence on the last year of the Alan Taylor Residence being used to house medical students. That was 1989, the same year that I qualified. So she is now somebody who is very active as part of the Healthcare Heroes Memorial. Over to you, Dr. Nozuko Mgabayi. We heard that Dr. Sipula used to dance quite a lot in the Kumbas, and when you got to Natal in 1989, you actually were one of those people as a first-year student that danced quite a lot, interacting with senior people. Over to you, Dr. Mgabayi.
Thank you, Program Director, Dr. Fundile Nyathi. If you will allow me, I will not show my video because I also have load shedding. So if I do, I'll be showing the dark. Thank you. Because that is where I was going to start, and you've already started for me. When I heard about Dr. Malombo's social life at RES, I felt like I knew Dr. Malombo. I felt like I knew Dr. Sipula way back then, although I got to hear and know about him much later in life. Thanks to Prof. Rudo Mativa for that elaborate description of the social life of RES, which I was part of, as you say, for only a year. I'd also like to declare that I have looked at the attendance register. In fact, when I was asked to do this Hippocratic Oath this morning, and I looked at the speakers, and I felt quite small. Having read what Dr. Norman Sipula has done in his young life, I felt, I was very small to be asked to do this honor. So I do not take it lightly. And I'm glad that it's in the evening, because I might have to answer to my head of department tomorrow if it was during the day, because I see she's also here. And that is Dr. Sibongile Zungu, who is the acting head of department of the Gauteng Department of Health that I work for. So I'd like to say, I will do the Hippocratic Oath, but firstly, I'd like to greet the family, the bereaved family, and greet the clergy, and say all protocol observed in the interest of time. So I would like, I'm not sure, Dr. Fundi, if you are able to open the videos for all the doctors that are on the platform. Because when we read the Hippocratic Oath, we ask all the medical doctors to raise their right hand. And when it's a physical memorial, the person that reads the oath reads the one line and the rest follow. But because it's an online one and we have time constraints, I will only read and the rest can raise their hands if they can. So the Hippocratic Oath goes, declaration of a doctor. As a doctor and member of the medical profession, I solemnly pledge that I will do my best to serve humanity, caring for the sick, promoting good health, and alleviating pain and suffering. I will care for all patients equally and not allow prejudice to influence my practice. I will respect the autonomy and dignity of my patients and will uphold their confidentiality. I will acknowledge my patients' physical, psychological, and social needs and assist them to make informed decisions that reflect their own values and beliefs. I will reflect on my practice and recognize my limits. I will seek to increase my understanding and skills and promote the advancement of medicine as both a teacher and a learner. I will work towards a fairer distribution of health resources and oppose policies in breach of human rights. I will look after my own physical, mental, and emotional well-being in my personal and professional life. I shall never intentionally cause harm to my patients and will have the utmost respect for human life. I will practice medicine with integrity, humility, honesty, and compassion. I recognize that the practice of medicine is a privilege with which comes considerable responsibility, and I will not abuse my position. I make this declaration sincerely, freely, and upon my honor. So this is the Hippocratic Oath that all doctors, before they are awarded the degree, the junior degree of medicine, which is MBCHB, which is Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, have to take the oath and abide by. And listening to all the speeches ahead of me, I think all of us on this platform can honestly say, indeed, Dr. Sepula lived by the Hippocratic Oath. He went beyond medicine. It says here, I will seek to increase my understanding and skills and promote the advancement of medicine as both a teacher and a learner. He went even beyond that, it's been mentioned. He did something that most of us doctors don't do, which is use our right brain and use our creative side. A lot of us live on our left brain and we don't do much outside medicine. So with those words and reading of the Hippocratic Oath, I'd like also to say condolences, deepest condolences to the family. And Umfundisi Uchilo xa evula wathi uDr. Sepula ran his race and he finished his race. So then it remains for all of us remaining behind to ask ourselves, what is our purpose on this earth? Because clearly Dr. Norman really did run his race and he finished his life purpose. Thank you very much, Dr. Nyat.
Thank you very much, Dr. Mkabayi. Because of time constraints, we'll be skipping some of the items that were there, but we would like to have a vote of thanks from somebody representing the family. Prophet Siani Marima Shihunda, if you are there, can you please give us a vote of thanks before I close the session today? We have had challenges with the family where, because of load shedding that was started this morning, quite a number of family members could not connect. But other people are connecting via Facebook, following via Facebook and via YouTube. So let's also know then that it's not only the 36 people that are here, many are following on the other social media channels. So is somebody from the family available for the vote of thanks, or should I go ahead and work towards closure?
Thank you, Siani Marima Shuhula. Do you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you very well. Okay.
Good evening, everybody, my brother's colleagues, my brother's ex-colleagues. I really appreciate your gesture. As a family, we feel so honored to know this part of him. Dada, Prof. Rudo, Erev Tov, Dr. Senga Riperile. I want to say that, even though we didn't go to Allantale, our brother was able to take us to Allantale. There are some stories that I can vividly remember. One of them is that one day there was a strike at Allantale, and as students were marching, one of the students who was not even, we didn't even know what they were marching for, Moodley, I think Naidu, came marching in front of everybody and say, Botha is a terrorist, Botha is a terrorist, and he was arrested, and yet he didn't even know what they were marching for. So when at home you come in and get people talking and you don't know what you just answer without listening to say, don't be a bother, a terrorist. So one of the things that I also remember is that Dr. Senga, Gokwane at home, Akashiwasani was looking forward to your graduation. And when you came back home with a black garment, she was disappointed. For my son, how can you spend so many years far away to come back with black garment in my house? So those are the things that he used to share with us. He was not only a doctor to the community, he was a doctor in the house. We have an uncle who's frail. Every time he will report that he's not feeling well, he stays in Giani. It doesn't matter what time Butu will hear that uncle's not fine. He will drive and go to Giani. And if it needs him to take him somewhere else, he will do it. So we have lost. He was our family doctor. We really want to say thank you for all what you have done. We received the certificate with gratitude. And the words that you have spoken here, although I might be the only one who have been listening, I will go back and tell them, they will echo in our hearts and will cherish them. I want to take this time to thank Dr. Maggie Mujapelo. We are all gathered here, but we don't know what was happening behind the scene. You know, I think it was from Monday, she has been sleeping after 3 o'clock. This is how dedicated she is. But also as a pastor, I'll say, doctors, please take care of yourselves. We appreciate your service. But the advice is that you give us that we need to rest. Practice that also, because the body gets tired. And we can only recuperate if we take enough sleep. So I'm encouraging all of you in this platform to say, please take care of yourselves. On behalf of the children who could not connect, they really want to say thank you for being there for their father. And they want to appreciate the doctors who have been taking care of him. And we say it was just time. It was his time. The Bible that I read says, our days are written long before in the book of life, long before we are born. God has ordained these days. And we are grateful that he departed in this manner. He has nursed many, some of them were my friends who were affected by COVID. When I told them this, that my brother has passed on, they told me how he nursed them at their homes and he will frequently check their oxygen level and advise them what to do. So it's not only missed by the medical profession, but by the entire community. This gesture that you have shown us, please continue doing it to others. And we really appreciate it. And my prayer for you is that may the Lord, God of peace, sanctify you through and through and through. And may he keep your spirit, soul, and body blameless at the coming of the Lord. I thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pastor Joyce. Thank you very much. I think now we are reaching that point where we are going to close the session. But before I do so, there's a few messages that have come through via the social media channels, messages to the family. And I thought, let me just quickly read those. There is a message from Prof. Solira Daimani. May his soul rest in eternal peace. Malombo served our community very well. From Lorraine Makola, deepest sympathy to the Sipula family. May his soul rest in peace and rise in glory. Also from Zimele Ngoma, deep condolences to the family. From Edwin Lipota, my sincere heartfelt condolences to the bereaved family. It's a sad day to be saying farewell to a man of Malombo's caliber. Take refuge in the service sermon delivered by Reverend Moyane. Right, and then the last one, it's from Denga Makado. Itela, I'm struggling to read this one. It's in Sitsonga. You made whoever you came across feel very special. Till we meet again, Silumutaung, heartfelt condolences to the Sipula family. Violet Masimula, our heartfelt condolences to the Sipula family. A giant tree has fallen. Our hearts are broken. May you be comforted in the Lord. May your beautiful soul rest in eternal peace. That's about all in terms of the messages that have come through on this side. All right, Dr. Mix is telling me that the daughter to Dr. Sipula has managed to connect. So let's give that platform for that tribute. And then after that, we will then close the session. Mapefu Sipula, welcome. Unfortunately, ESCOM, sometimes the schedules can disrupt, plans like we had today. But we're glad that you have joined us. So please, the floor is yours. You can talk on behalf of the children of the late Dr. Malombo Sipula. That's how we called him, Dr. Malombo. He is Dr. Norman, but to us is Dr. Malombo.
Thank you so much. I think good evening, everyone, and sorry we weren't able to join earlier. But I think we just want to really just say thank you as Dr. Sipula's children. I think it's been a hard week, but I think the support from friends, family, colleagues has been really appreciated. He was very passionate about medicine. He was very passionate about his patients. And he was just very passionate about utilizing technology to advance medicine and increase access to medicine. And I think we pray and hope that, his legacy will continue and that his work will continue through his colleagues. And for us as his children to carry on his legacy I'll just speak briefly about Papa, you know, fondly known as Malombo. He was one of the greatest dads. I think we couldn't have asked for a better dad, you know, and it's been really heartwarming to hear what reach and impact that he's had, you know, because sometimes you just know him as Papa, you know, but today we've learned so much about him and how he's touched people's lives and how he's been able to do that through medicine. And I think we're just really, really appreciative of the medical fraternity and how you've supported him and you've worked together and you've kind of, through his kind of 30 years within the medical field. So I think we just really, really want to say thank you and appreciate all your support and all your messages. They really are consoling us. And I'd just really like to say thank you.
Thank you so much, Mapefu. All right. Now we actually have power back in 4 weeks. So we will have the last item being the song Time to Say Goodbye. That will be the song that will then, at the end, we will then stop the session. But there's just one message from Ayanda Jolome. Deepest condolences and heartfelt sympathy to the Sibula family. He was an exceptional human being, a very dear friend. May his soul rest in eternal peace with God and with his ancestors. All right, support, you can then play that song. At the end of the song, then I will declare the session closed. Thank you very much. Support, are you ready? All right, there's about item 14, but I'm not sure if we have not passed that. All right, item 14 is the audience greetings to the family, and we're supposed to unmute sound and cameras so that a picture can be taken. So can we try and do that quickly? Can we all, those who are able to switch on their cameras, a picture is going to be taken and that will then be delivered also to the family. So can we do that quickly before ESCOM hits another part? Of wherever you are. So please, let's switch on those cameras. I know the bandwidth can be a challenge in other parts of the country, but it would be nice if we have as many cameras switched on as possible. And also the mics, also unmuted. Dr. Max, that's what we need to do.
Hello, Fundi. Hi, Fundi.
Hi, Dr. Max.
Yeah, the people can unmute the video indeed, and then we can see Siani, who has played, as a family and the other family members, so that we can greet before we lock off. Okay. And we greet other colleagues away from us, who are far from us. Okay. But to the family, Siani, we didn't see you, but we were fortunate to see the daughter.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I am.
Yes, hi, Siani.
Hello, shalom, shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom, shalom, prophet, doctor. All thanks right. For your contribution.
All right, I think we are done that song that will then take us to the closure of the session. Are you ready to play the song? Mm-hmm.
sono solo sogno all'orizzonte, mancano le parole. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me, sì. Le finestre mostrare tutto il mio cuore che è acceso. Chiudi dentro me la luce che ho incontrato per strada.
Thank you very much. We have come to the end of this session. It's not easy when you are celebrating the life of somebody who was larger than life, you know, like Dr. Malombo, with so many aspects to his life. Thank you very much for taking your time in the middle of the week to actually come here and celebrate the life of this legend. And may we continue to do the same for others, you know, and other families that may find themselves in a similar situation. Dr. Max, thank you for the good work that you are doing as the healthcare, you know, as the Healthcare Heroes Memorial. We need to make sure that when one of us has checked out, you know, to be with the Lord, and we celebrate the impact, like the Reverend said earlier, it's really not about the duration of the life, but the impact, you know, the donation that they gave to humanity. So may we all go back and reflect on that when the same happens to us, we never know when that will happen. Let's live meaningful, impactful lives. Thank you very much. Until next time. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good night.
Bye.
'Hello, Nana.
Well done, team. Good night. Thank you. Thanks, Dr. Fundi.